Welcome to Top 10 News Channel. Today we will talk about top 5 musicians who just missed the 27 Club. Number 5. Tim Buckley. February 14, 1947, June 29, 1975, 28 years, 4 months, 15 days, 136 days past 27. Perhaps the artist whose legacy could have best been heightened by membership into the 27 Club is Tim Buckley. Buckley spent his near-decade-long career exploring different genres and styles of music, transitioning from folk to rock to psychedelic to jazz to a more soulful sound. With each subsequent album alienating some fans and engendering fanaticism in others. Upon his death from a heroin morphine alcohol overdose, Buckley's friend, Richard Keeling, was convicted of involuntary manslaughter for supplying the singer with the fatal drugs. Buckley has since been eclipsed in fame by his late son Jeff Buckley, whose drowning death at the age of 30 also narrowly missed his acceptance into the 27 Club. Number 4. Bix Beiderbecke. March 10, 1903. August 6, 1931, 28 years, 4 months, 24 days, 150 days past 27, probably the least known artist on the list. Bix Beiderbecke was a legendary jazz musician whose autodidactic cornet sound made him one of the most innovative musicians of his era and would have made him the aug of the 27 Club had his life been cut short a few months earlier. Beloved by jazz musicians and celebrated as one of the first white musicians to not only gain acceptance, but admiration, in the largely black world of early jazz. Beiderbecke's problems with alcohol eventually resulted in death during America's Prohibition period. His musical legacy is remembered at the Bix Beiderbecke Memorial Jazz Festival, which has been held annually in his hometown of Davenport, Iowa since 1972. Number 3. Nick Drake. June 19, 1948, November 25, 1974, 26 year, 5 months, 6 days, 206 days until 27th birthday. Although he released only 3 albums, Nick Drake has, in death, earned the cult status and widespread acclaim that eluded him in life. By the time he recorded his final album, Pink Moon, Drake's long-standing depression had incapacitated him so severely that he was unable to function and ultimately hospitalized. Drake died in his parents' home of an overdose of antidepressants nearly 6 months shy of his 27th birthday. Posthumous tributes include Dream Academy's 1985 song Life in a Northern Town, which was dedicated to the singer, as well as a music video for Black Eyed Dog, directed in 2007 by actor Heath Ledger, making Drake's final recording also one of Ledger's final artistic outputs before his own untimely death at 28. Number 2. Otis Redding. September 9, 1941, December 10, 1967, 26 years, 3 months, 1 day, 274 days until 27th birthday. Hard to believe that Otis Redding was barely 26 when he died in 1967 from a fatal plane crash. By the time his plane plunged into water 3 miles outside of the intended Madison, Wisconsin airport runway, Redding had already achieved legendary status amongst his peers for his solo and duet recordings with Carla Thomas, as well as through his high-energy performance style. 3 days prior to his death, The Big O recorded Sittin' on the Dock of the Bay, which proved to be his biggest hit and was a marked departure from his shake. Otis' sound that defined his earlier career and made him the enigmatic star of Stax Records. Number 1. Hillel Slovak. April 13, 1962, June 25, 1988, 26 years, 2 months, 12 days, 292 days until 27th birthday. Although Hillel Slovak died from a heroin overdose before the Red Hot Chili Peppers gained enduring fame, he was the seedling from which the band's idiomatic sound grew. Prior to forming RHCP, Slovak was guitarist for his high school band Anthem. Dissatisfied with the group's bassist, Slovak taught his friend Michael Flea Balzari to play bass and, From that, Red Hot Chili Peppers was eventually formed. Upon his death, Slovak was replaced with guitarist John Frusciante, at the time a teenager with zero band experience, but whose playing style was hugely influenced by his predecessor. Arguably Hillel Slovak's greatest role in music history was that of a mentor, in that protégés Flea and Frusciante have become two of the most celebrated bassists and guitarists, respectively, in music. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe button, like and share. Thank you.